The enemies of Christ thought they had won. The Pharisees and those people, the teachers of the law and the Levites, they said, we finally did what we needed to do. We stopped this thing. We stopped this infection. We stopped this thing coming on.
What did they not know?
But he couldn't endure it. Everybody scattered, and he was alone, and he had to fend for himself. See, before he had Christ right next to him.
Yeah, all right.
He had Christ right next to him that calmed the storm.
Right.
He had Christ next to him that did some mighty works. Yeah. He had Christ next to him. He was like, hey, as long as you're right here, as long as you're right here, I am willing to fight.
Uh-huh.
But when Jesus got taken away, all this fight
happened. Yeah, that's right.
Wow.
That's right.
Yeah.
He had to understand on that.
Right.
So anyway, let's go back. So you got the disciples. They had just been through the triumphant entry. People were excited. Everybody's happy. He goes into the temple. He cleans out the temple. He's healing folks and doing all that. So the week is going on. And they're probably excited. It's Passover. This is supposed to be, if you haven't, I've read this somewhere, and I think it is. This was not only a regular Sabbath or Passover. This was a high Sabbath. This was the year of Jubilee Sabbath.
Wow, okay.
This was the one everybody's debts are forgiven. Everybody gets to be restored. You know, they're thinking, man, you know the disciples had to be thinking, this is it.
Oh, yeah.
This is it. You know, this is the time that this Messiah that we have been, this man that we have been believing is the Messiah is about to take over.
Yeah.
And we're all going to be some important folks with him.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. They had to believe, this has to be the time. Yeah. They're going to do this, they're going to do the Passover meal. They're going through the Passover meal, and they're thinking everything's ready, everything's good, and they go to the garden, and all of a sudden he's praying. Like, what is he praying? That's why they fall asleep, because they're thinking, it can't be that bad.
Yeah.
Hey, I mean, he's ready, man. He's ready to take over. And then they come from the one that they thought was the Messiah. They come from the one that they thought was going to bring freedom.
Right.
Healing and blessings and exaltation for Israel. They thought he was the one that was going to stop out one and rule,
right.
Start leading
right.
In righteousness with them on the 12 thrones, judging the children of Israel. Because he told them that, right?
Yeah.
They were ready for this. They were looking for it. They were ready for it. Other disciples, the thousands, well, the hundreds that made it follow, they're always thinking, this is it. Come on now, let's get into this. Our Christ, this is his time. But then he doesn't fight.
Yeah.
He doesn't fight. What do you mean? Put up your sword.
Right.
Isn't right. This the time to dig in, to fight for what you want, to fight for everything you said? They didn't understand.
Right.
I don't even know if I would understand.
Right.
I don't even know if I understand today. We look to the resurrection.
Yeah.
Right.
And we know what happened. Right. We don't understand what they were going through.
Right. That's right.
And these people were just probably totally confused.
Yeah.
I saw this man raise a dead man that was dead for 3 days. I saw this man walk on the water.
Yeah.
I saw this man glowing on the mountain. God came in a cloud and spoke to us about him. I saw all of this. Why aren't you fighting?
Right. Right.
Why aren't you pursuing what we think you're supposed to pursue?
Right. Right.
So here we are. And the enemies was like, we got him in.
Nah, that's fine.
They take him in. We have to talk about the crucifixion before we get to the resurrection.
Yeah.
Okay. They take him in. They put him before Caiaphas and what was the other guy's name?
Pontius.
No, not Pontius. Caiaphas was the high priest, and I think that was his father, and another was the high priest. Anyway, he takes him before the high priest. And they're just messing with him. Yeah, it's amazing to me. They said, tell us. I adjure you before God to tell us if you're the Christ. And Jesus said, yes, I am. Like, oh!
Yeah.
That's what they're wanting to say. Yeah. Like they go to the mention, oh, we got you now.
Yeah. Right.
Kill him. came before Pilate. Pilate then says him and harm. I don't know if Pilate was really all that. I just think Pilate didn't like the Jews. And so he didn't really want to do what they wanted.
Yeah.
I think it really got to him when they said, he says he's a king. And if anybody says they're the king, they're not a friend of Pilate, then anybody, you know, right. You need to do something. He was like, okay. Now he got him. Now they go to him. They got Pilate where they wanted him. They put him in the corner and said, you must do this because otherwise you are defying Caesar. You didn't have that.
Right.
That was his prayer. That was his power. That was his authority. And he understood. He did what he did. And here's Jesus saying, they mock him, they beat him, they spit on him. Do all that stuff, they trail him out there, they nail him to the cross, and he's up there dying. And then they start mocking. And you see the people out there mocking, and the high priest is saying, he saved us. Why don't he come on down and save himself? They didn't believe.
Huh.
That was the sign, that might have been the sign that they said they were looking for. You know, show us a sign that shows you can do these things. And it ain't gonna be a sign, except a sign. Other people mocking about this and about that. Laughing at him, saying, come on down, man.
Right.
What's the matter? You say you can do it. And then you got all the disciples. They're not close. They're back. But they're watching in the distance. They're watching these things happen. Some of the women are closer than the guys. They're afraid. And they're watching this. And every hope and every dream that they have is mine. It's Jesus.
Yeah. Yeah.
Everything that they had. All their excitement, all their enthusiasm, all their expectations are dying. Don't you think that they were waiting at the base that they can get any minute now?
Yes, sir.
He's going to say something or do something, or God is going to show up or something. He's going to come down from that cross. He's going to explode with power, and he's going to do the things that he's supposed to do.
Yeah, that's what they thought.
And they waited. And they waited, and he gave up the ghost, and it got darker.
Wow.
It got darker. And all their expectations began to fall again. See, it fell in the garden, and they probably raised it a little. Then it fell again. And they stuck it in the ground, and they take it to the tomb, and they're kind of sitting there watching this. And they are probably thinking, that's it?
Yeah.
Oh, it's over.
Right.
It's all done. Might as well go home.
Yeah.
He thought he had something here that was just him.
Wow. All right.
Anybody identify with that sometimes?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let's go ahead and read a little bit of this. We're going to read a few verses out of Luke chapter 24. We're going to start with verse 1, and we're going to go to 6, kind of read the truth out of the resurrection story. Luke chapter 24, we're going to start with verse 1. Already from the King James Version.
I think we lost you.
Okay, now we're going to have this on. Can anybody say that again?
I can't hear you. Not very well.
Nobody can hear me?
No, I can't hear you.
Can you help me out then?
I can hear you.
Raise the roof. Raise the roof.
I heard that.
But they were still so perplexed.
Yeah.
And we sit here and think, how could they be? But we're not in their shoes.
No.
We don't understand.
Right.
As they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said unto them, this is what the angel said, why seek ye the living among the dead? I think that's a powerful statement right there. Why seek the living among the dead? Why are you seeking life when you know dead is supposed to be? Jesus has told you he's going to rise again. Why are you even here? Why are you checking out the tomb?
All right.
Why are you seeking the living among the dead?
Yeah, all right.
Would you seek for someone alive in a gravesite in a plot of ground? Would you seek for somebody that is living and vibrant in a dead tomb somewhere? Why are you seeking the living among the dead?
All right.
They didn't come there to worship. They came here to mourn.
Yeah. Right.
They didn't come to celebrate something, celebrate life. They came here to weep and moan over a lost opportunity.
Yeah, that's right.
All right.
That's what they were there for. And the angel's like, why? Why?
Yeah.
He ain't here.
Right.
He's not here. Don't you get anything? He's here. He wasn't there. Why are you seeking the living among the dead?
Yeah.
He is not here, but is risen. Woo. Remember how he spake to you when he was yet in Galilee. So he's trying to remind them, you people in the, you're in the wrong spot looking for Jesus.
Right.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That might be the last place you saw him, but that's not where he is now.
Yeah, all right.
He told you, I'm going to see you in Galilee when I rise up.
Yeah.
I said, I'm going to meet you here.
Yeah.
But they didn't go there. Their faith. Okay. Let's keep going. So we're going to go down, we're going to jump down to 10, we're going to just 10 and 11. It was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, and Mary, the mother of James, and other women were with them, which told these things unto the apostles. So after this, Jesus shows up. After the angel tells him, why see the living among the dead, Jesus shows up, actually, and they finally see him. So then they're like, they're getting excited. They're like, hey, okay. So you got two, three women that are excited. Now, they say the women didn't have a testimony. I don't know. I tend to believe most of them. My wife tells me, so I don't know how they thought back then. But they told the apostles, they took in their minds, but their words seemed to them as idle tales, and they believed not. Here's a witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, the man that you saw calm the sea, heal the sick, raise the dead, cast out demons, go about doing good, healing all that are oppressed, speaking wisdom, speaking life, speaking truth for everyone, not afraid to do anything. This is the man. And he said, hey, I'm going to rise in you. And they come and tell the people. Tell the apostles, the 11 that were left, the apostles. We've seen the Lord. And they're like, That's a bunch of mess. Peter even has to run and go check it out for himself. He goes check for the living among the dead. Him and John run to the tomb. They run to the tomb trying to figure this thing out. And they're still perplexed. They're like, it's got to be something. He couldn't have risen. He can't be alive. They know they are fools. They're a bunch of fools.
Yeah.
They don't know what they're talking about. Amen. Everybody okay so far?
Yes, sir.
Let's go on down to 13. Now this is the road to Emmaus. And behold, two of them went the same day to a village called Emmaus, which was from Jerusalem about 3 score furlongs. So if anybody's not with a furlong yet, I read it somewhere, it's about seven
Whoa.
So I guess the furlong is about what?
17, my father said.
Something like that, but anyway. About 7 miles from Jerusalem. And they talked together all the things which had happened. And it came to pass while they can, now they're talking about this. They're talking about this. They'll get into this. They're talking about all the things that have happened. And it came to pass while they communed together and reasoned, Jesus himself drew near and went with them. But their eyes were hidden that they should not know him. Why Jesus concealed himself, I don't know. But he decided to conceal himself. And he said unto them, what manner of communications are these? What are you guys talking about? That you have one another as you walk and say, he's like, I've been listening to you. What are you guys talking about? What's going on here? And one of them said, whose name was Clopas, answered and said, Are thou only a stranger in the Jews? It's like, where in the world have you been? Where in the world have you been? Everybody knows this. And has not known these things that have come to pass in these days? And he said unto them, what thing? This is Jesus talking. And they said, unto him concerning Jesus of Nazareth. You know, Jesus of Nazareth?
Yeah.
Which was a mighty prophet in deed and word before God and all the people. And how the chief priests and the rulers delivered him to be condemned to death and to crucify him. But we trusted, this is it, but we trusted that he had been he, but we trusted that it had been he which would have redeemed Israel. See, that's it.
Right.
Jesus died. They trusted him to redeem Israel. They trusted him to be a conquering king in the ways that they saw.
Right.
They trusted him to do things a certain way. They trusted him to move about in the way they wanted to move about and finish the way they thought he should finish.
Right.
And they're like,
just like his birth.
We thought he was the one. We thought he was the one.
Yeah.
That's right.
And besides all this, today is the third day since these things were done. Yea, and certain women also of our company made us astonished, which were early at the sepulchre. So they were some of the same people that Mary and all her came to say, the Lord has risen, we saw him. And it was idle tales to them.
Wow. Yeah.
We thought he was the Messiah. We thought he was good. And these women, he's saying, they told us these things. But really? Really?
Yeah.
Really? They can't be trusted. And when they found out his body, they came saying that they had also seen a vision of angels who said he was alive. So he made a testimony of angels. They still couldn't believe it. And a certain man which were with us went to the sepulchre and found it even as the woman had said, but they saw him not. Still looking for the living among the dead.
Yeah.
Then he said unto them, O fools, slow of heart. He calls them fools. Slow of heart. To believe all the prophets have spoken. Even him. I'm going to die. And in 3 days I'll rise again. They didn't believe. They didn't understand. They didn't understand. Ought not Christ have to suffer these things and to enter his glory? And then Jesus goes and gives them a Bible study, an Old Testament Bible study on Christ.
Amazing.
Amen.
Amen.
So let's jump down to verse 36. And as they thus spoke, Jesus himself. Now this is after. So I have to fill these gaps in. So after Jesus gave them the Bible study, he broke bread with them and revealed himself to these 200 men. So there, another testimony. Now they see him alive, and they know that Christ is alive. So they walked 7 miles from Jerusalem to Emmaus, right? Jesus reveals himself, and they're like, oh, now we've got to come tell somebody. We've got to let the apostles know we were fools. Jesus is alive. They go 7 miles back just to tell them. Just to tell them Jesus is alive. I think that's amazing.
Yeah.
That's a resurrection part. That's an understanding of the resurrection. He is actually alive. Everything that we thought,
yeah.
Everything that we were expecting can happen.
Yes, sir.
Because he is alive.
Yeah. Yeah.
He is alive. But we know Since we have the resurrection, the power of God, to come up out of the grave.
Amazing.
To come up out of the grave. Burst through a stone wall. A stone in the stone in front of the wall. Get through all of that and ascend to heaven. Here is our God, the power of the resurrection. But if you notice, actually the actual resurrection was in total obscurity.
Right.
No one saw him.
Right.
Resurrected. It was only after the fact.
Mm-hmm.
See, it was funny. The announcement of his birth by angels. People, you know, the wise men coming and giving you gifts to him. Even the announcement of Jesus coming into Jerusalem, announcing for the resurrection, was obscure.
That's true.
It was after he was resurrected, after he showed himself, and all the excitement started. But the actual resurrection, to me, is amazing. It's obscure. We'll get
all right.
What I think of.
All right.
Now we know that death is not the end, right? We know that death is not the end.
Yes, sir.
That is a hope of knowing Jesus Christ. As the end of your life, as your Savior, you know that it doesn't matter that death is not the end.
Right.
We know that. Yes. Give me an amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
But I'm not just talking about physical death. It's not just physical death that we're dealing with. Eternal life begins right now.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
And that eternal life is an ever-increasing life, a more abundant life right now. Now, we're going to talk about 3 days. Friday, he's dying. Friday, he's dying. And everybody is weak and sad. You don't know what to do. Waiting for something. Waiting and waiting for something to happen before he's on the cross. And I can just see them just waiting. Come on, Jesus. Come on, do what you do. Come on, you show us so many things. Come on down. They were probably not mocking him like some of them would come down for the cross. They were saying, yes, come down for the cross and show these people you are the
Messiah.
And then he dies. And their hope is lost. Yeah. And they've got to go through a whole Saturday.
Yeah.
And just think about this. This was the high Saturday. This was the seventh Saturday. This was the Saturday where everybody gets forgiven. And everything's supposed to be great. But everything they hope they got to go through this period of nothing. There's no Messiah.
Yeah.
Our Messiah, our hopes are gone. Cast that aside. Our dreams for righteousness lie. Cast that aside. Cast it aside. Cast it aside. Mourning through. Instead of celebrating the Passover.
Right.
Instead of celebrating the Jubilee, they were in mourning. It's done. It's over. It's finished. It's
dead.
A whole Saturday of nothing.
Yeah.
And then it's, you can see how that can just drive you in.
Oh, yeah.
Drive you like, it's hopeless now.
Yeah.
It's hopeless. It's hopeless. It wasn't him. Right? They were right. It wasn't him. We thought he was, but it wasn't him. He wasn't the one to help us. He wasn't the one to do it. He couldn't do it. We thought he could, but he couldn't help us.
Right.
And Saturday, and Sunday night. And it was still a shake. It was still a little unbelief. When yes. Jesus does show up.
Right.
When Jesus just shows up to you.
Yes, sir.
When Jesus shows himself to you.
Yes, sir.
When Jesus does it to you.
Yes, sir.
All your doubts in the faith of the name of you. And you see him for who he is and what he can do, then all of a sudden, when it comes to transitions, we already know what heaven is like. We think. Jesus said, no one can take my life. I give it freely. I'm willing to give up my life. Are we willing to give up our lives? Our physical life, but also our self life.
Yeah.
Can't believe what you're talking about. Are we willing to give up our self life? See, we may be willing to die physically for our belief, just like Peter was. See, Peter was willing to die. And he said it, and he believed it. And God said, but this day you'll be mine. Because he couldn't fight like he promised to fight. I believe if God said, yeah, take up your swords, Peter would have fought to the
end.
He would have swung until he couldn't swing anymore.
Yeah.
You know, he was willing to do that. But when it came to the real fight of self,
go ahead.
Where Christ is not by your side, right there in his understanding, he couldn't do it. He let go.
Amazing.
And that's why he's like, I've got to preserve myself.
Amazing.
I have to protect myself.
Wow.
If I say I'm part of him, they might have me in the room next time. They might have me on trial with it. I've got to protect myself.
Yeah. Amazing.
Are we willing to sacrifice our self-love? See, when he was alone, he was scared, and that's why he denied him. He thought he was alone. Mm-hmm. And he thought he had to protect himself. Sometimes I believe we do that. We think we're alone, we think we're on our own, we think we gotta do something, we want to protect ourselves. We have to protect ourselves. Where is God now? Is he on trial? Is he in the tomb? What is going on?
Yeah, all right.
But that's the easy part. The tough part is dying. So fighting for natural life, but dying to self is the hard one. Are we willing to give up our self-life?
Mm.
Some of the things that we need to die to, just think about this. We need to die of anger.
Oh, yeah, amen.
Right?
Yes.
We need to die of covetousness.
Yes.
We need to die to envy and envious of other people's name.
Yeah.
We need to die to shame. We need to die to guilt. There's a lot of things that we think hold us together.
Yes, sir.
If I can't be angry, what about God left?
Right.
We say we don't want to be angry, but how many of us love to talk about our anger exposure?
Go ahead.
So-and-so said so-and-so, and I said so-and-so.
Yeah. Right.
You said, oh, man, I did it right for you. Proud.
Right.
When you die.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Upset because we don't understand, because the resurrection hasn't come in. And we love it if, as soon as we got rid of anger, peace just pop right up.
Right.
But sometimes there's a Saturday in between.
Yeah. All right, Pastor. Yeah.
Yeah. You might have to go through a Saturday, but you can be assured. You can be assured. You can be assured that resurrection is coming.
Yes, sir.
Resurrection is coming. Amen.
Amen.
And this is your rock. This could be your life. So this Saturday in between death and the resurrection, go through it. Not like the disciples when we're always lost. But stay enthusiastic. Because you know, through this, Jesus rising from the dead. Jesus rising from the dead.
Yes, sir.
In life, in power, in authority. When he rose from the dead, he said, all power in the whole universe has been given to me.
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
It is nothing that is not under my feet. All in heaven and in earth. In heaven and in earth.
Amazing.
It was given to me.
Amen.
Amazing.
And that's the power of the resurrection.
Yes, sir.
We talked about this Wednesday. Jesus, for the joy that was set before him on the cross, despite the shame. And now see that the right hand of God. Through his submission, through his death, burial, a day in hell, or whatever people say, some of you look at, I don't know, I'm thinking he went to heaven. Because if he didn't die a spiritual death, we didn't die a spiritual death.
Right?
He died physically for us, and he died spiritually for us.
Yes, sir.
Because that was a spiritual death. We were all in before we came to Christ.
Yes, sir.
We were all spiritual then. He died that day so we can live spiritually.
That's right.
Amen. He died spiritually so we can live spiritually. And he did that long enough to say, it's finished. Yeah. Boom.
Yeah.
I'm coming back. I'm coming back. We know we can do it. So we say this a lot, and I was thinking about this. We say this a lot. Jesus died as us. No, Jesus died with us.
Yes, sir.
He died too.
Yeah, that's
right. But we're alive by the Spirit.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're alive by the Spirit. So that Spirit, he exchanged a dead spiritual man with a living spiritual man.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. One thing that we are still working on, if that's a good word, is dead spiritual man is dead. The new spiritual man is alive in Christ.
Yes.
However, the new spiritual man that's alive has all the memories of the dead spiritual man. And yeah. Tends to go back to the dead head.
Oh. Yeah.
Instead of the living head.
All right.
Yes. And we need to let those things be buried.
Amen.
Crucified, be buried. Die completely like this, so the resurrection life,
amen.
Jesus Christ can rise up there.
Yes.
Give me an amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So that is where we are. And like I said, it may just be that resurrection that comes up might be unnoticed. It might take a minute. The resurrection peace that is coming, the contentment that is coming, there might be this period that has actually happened, but you don't understand.
All right.
It doesn't make sense. It's idle tales to you. You don't get it.
Yeah, all right.
Like I said, the resurrection was really quiet.
Amazing.
At least, you know, I mean, I know, well, I said the soldiers saw rumbling and stuff, but nobody really talks about, I saw Jesus come up out of the grave.
Right.
They didn't say that. They just saw it happen. In you, it might be the same way.
Go ahead.
But you know, and you know, and you know, and you know, and you know, or should know, that it's coming.
Amen.
Amen.
That if I can be crucified, if self can be crucified, true life is being resurrected.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
He placed the Holy Spirit. Jesus died. He died. And he made a way for you to have a relationship with God.
Yes.
Greater than Moses.
Right.
Think about it.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I mean, Moses walked to God face to face.
Yes.
Right.
Moses wanted to do his presence and spoke to him face to face. But the what Jesus did was even greater than that.
Yes, sir.
He wants us to have such an intimate relationship with the Father. He wants us to have that relationship that goes beyond just friendship.
Yes, sir.
It goes beyond just even, you know, whatever, it goes beyond that. Almost even beyond a husband and wife with similar. It says, for this cause,
yes, sir,
a man will leave his father and mother and be cleaved unto his wife. And the two shall become one flesh. Right? Mm. And then Paul said, takes that and says, but I speak a mystery concerning Christ and his church.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, that's right.
And that's what he is doing for us.
Yes, sir.
He is making us one with him.
Yes, sir.
The Holy Spirit.
Amen.
He is going to cleave to us.
Yes, sir.
Until we can become one with him.
Hallelujah.
That's how close that relationship
is.
More than Abraham. Oh, what a faithful man Abraham was.
Yeah.
Right. More than Moses. What a powerful man Moses was.
Right.
More than a conqueror. What a conqueror was Joshua and David.
Yeah.
Conquerors. More than, you know, more loving than David. More than anybody in the Bible. He says, this is the relationship that I have made a way for you to have.
Right. Amazing.
And that is a resurrection life coming out of you that you can be one with God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That is your destiny.
Yes, sir.
I have to claim that over you now. That is your
destiny. Amen.
That is your right. That is what Jesus paved the way for us to all walk in. There is nothing holding you back except a little bit of misunderstanding, misconception.
Amen.
I'm claiming for you right now. I'm claiming for you right now a relationship with God that you've never had before.
Amen.
Amen. A relationship that brings you beyond the natural ordinary circumstances and brings you up into the heavens. It's yours to get. I'm telling you right now. Don't wait. Don't wait for something to happen. Allow it to happen.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen.